Yes, Udayan, so in that RLC assignment, at that time you didn't know, okay? But now you know how to draw the phasor diagram, okay? So better you draw the phasor diagram and upload that in Google Classroom, in lab, and I will change your marks. Actually, some of you didn't draw that phasor diagram. Okay, so yes, if you can, you can submit that again. I will check that and update the marks. Okay, is that clear, Udayan? Okay,
sir, fine. But it will be marked late, no?
No. I will look into that matter. There will be no problem. Okay.
Okay,
I will update the marks. No issue regarding that. Okay. Good afternoon, everyone, again. It's almost 1:10, so we can start now. Okay, and I told you that the most of the theoretical portion that I already covered in previous classes, okay, and already all the study materials were uploaded in the Google Classroom. You can check that. Okay, so now in today's class, we will discuss various types of numerical based on the theoretical portion I discussed with you in previous classes, okay, in AC circuit. So is the screen visible now? Response?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So first we will discuss the previous assignment that I gave you, okay, to check whether you can solve that or not. And please remember that whenever you are going to solve any AC circuit or DC circuit numerical, try to draw the diagrams. Okay, try to draw the diagrams. Here, look, it is given that a three-phase star-connected system with 400-volt line-to-line is connected to three loads. So what is the first point given? It is star-connected, okay? So first, I am going to draw the star connection, okay? You can draw like this. This is your reference now. That is your red phase. Okay, this is your yellow, this is your blue, okay? Or you can draw like this also. That's up to you, whatever, which diagram you want to prefer, okay? At this point, this will be your red, this will be your yellow, this will be your blue. That means three phase in star connection, okay? And always remember that star connection, you can identify by looking at this neutral. This is the neutral point, okay? So here, 400 volt line to line is given, correct? So what is the 400 volt? If I connect one multimeter, okay? If I connect one multimeter and the two leads are connected, one lead is connected across B, another lead is connected across R. So whatever voltage is measured, that is the line voltage, okay? And instead of this B, if you connect this line, this lead in neutral, this is the neutral point. If you connect at neutral, then whatever voltage you are observing, that is the phase voltage. I hope you remember that, okay? Yes or no? Do you remember that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So here look that three loads are given, 25 angle 0, 11 angle 20, 15 angle 10. So all these loads are expressed in polar formation. So they already helped you. Okay, so whoever sets this question, he already helped you by converting the Cartesian to polar. Okay, and already you know that in case of multiplication or the division, the polar formation is easier to operate. Yes, so this resistance, this impedance is connected in per phase. Okay. And look, the voltage is given as line voltage. So what you have to do first, you have to calculate the phase voltage. Correct. And in star connection, I hope you remember, in star connection, the phase voltage into root 3 is your line voltage. Okay. V phase into root 3 is your line voltage. So here line voltage is given. So from this equation, calculate the phase voltage. It is easy. Okay. So VL by root 3, 400 by root 3, that is 231 volt. Okay. This is the phase volt. That means VRN or VBN. Okay. This voltage you can also write as VRN. N or NR, okay? And this magnitude is also equal to VBN. This magnitude is also equals to VYN. Okay, now what we need to do? We need to calculate the phase current. Okay, so in R phase, in this phase, what current is flowing? That is I1. Okay, so that's why 230 divided by 25 angle 0. So you are getting 9.24 angle 0. You can calculate this one using the calculator. Okay, this one is easy. Now in next case, when I2 current we need to calculate, here what is the voltage value? The voltage magnitude will remain same, but angle It is 120 degree lagging. Look here. It is lagging by 120 degree. So that's why minus 120 degree is written here. Okay. It is 120 degree. So that's why this minus 120 degree is written. So then magnitude will be divided, 231 divided by 11. From there, you are getting 21. And from this angle, you are getting minus 120 plus 20. Right. So from there, you are getting minus 100 ampere. Is the calculation I2 clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now next, we are going to calculate the I3. Okay. In case of I3, look here, it is written as 231 angle 120, positive 120. Why? Okay. Here, look, this B phase, you can say that it is either 120 degree leading. Okay, listen very carefully. Either I can say it is 120 degree leading, or I can say 240 degree lagging. Both are same, isn't it? Both are same. 120 degree leading or 240 degree lagging. So if instead of writing this one, if you write 230 angle minus 240 degree, okay, divided by 15 angle 10 degree, okay, so the magnitude will remain same, 15.4 angle minus 250 degree. Okay, so this value will be minus 250 degree. So both these two values, 15.4 angle 110 degree, 15.4 angle 250 degree, both are same. Okay, if you convert this into the Cartesian form or rectangular form, you will get the same value. Okay, you can do that on your own. It is easy, right? So that's how the phase currents can be measured, right? So next we are going to calculate the power. Okay, so now the line current is also same, correct? Line current is also same here. Yes. Okay, so line current is equal to the phase current every time. Okay, so I can write instead of 110 degree, I can write this one as 15.4 angle minus 250 degree. You can write that. Both are same. Both will give you the same value. Okay. Now, what is the power in phase? The power in phase is VI cos phi. Okay. This is the per phase power. Now, you will ask me that, sir, you told me that in power equals to root 3 into VL into IL into cos theta. Yes, I told you that. But this one is the total power, not per phase power. Okay, if your voltage level and current level are same for all the three branches, then total power you can calculate using this equation. Okay, but look here. In different branches, the current is different. Okay, so that's why we have to take the normal equation, normal calculation. Okay, I can write this one as P T Okay, now look how this equation is developed. Vi cos theta. Okay, P total equals to root 3. What is VL in case of star? That is root 3 into V phase. Okay, what is IL? That is also I phase. Next is your cos theta. Okay, so root 3 into 3, that will be 3 into V phase into I phase into cos theta. Okay, now divide it. So P total divided by 3 will give you per phase power. P per phase. So what is the equation you just derived? That is V phase into I phase into cos theta. So that's how you are getting this equation. Okay, V phase into I phase into cos theta. Now, why this equation is used here? Because current values are different. The system is not symmetrical. Okay, impedances are different. So that's why we have to adopt this process. So now per phase power you can calculate, that is P1, P2 and P3. Okay, so now you will get the angle difference also, right? What was the V1, your V phase for phase 1? V phase 1, that is your 231 angle 0, okay? What is your V phase for second phase? That is 231 angle minus 120 degree. Okay. So look here, what is the difference between these two angle? That is 20 degree. Okay. Similarly here, I3 here also, if you write 110, you will get 10 degree. Or if you write 250, you will see the difference, that is your also 10 degree, right? If it is V phase 3, I am writing here 231 angle minus 240. So what is the difference? That is only 10 degree. So that's how you are getting this power. Now, if you add this power, you will get the total power. Okay. Now, the current in the neutral. So how will you calculate the current in the neutral? That is IR plus IY plus IB. The three phase current you should add. Okay. So these are written in polar. So you have to convert this into Cartesian formation, okay? If you convert this into Cartesian formation, you will generate this value. You will get this value. So that is the current in the neutral. So now look that since the system is not symmetrical, the neutral has one particular current, that value is not zero. Okay, so since this system is unbalanced, so we cannot apply this system into practical case. Otherwise, all the current, this unbalanced amount of current will flow through the neutral. Okay, so that is the problem here. Is that clear? Is the concept clear? Or should I repeat once again? Or which part you don't understand? Tell me. Is this numerical clear to everyone?
Yes, sir. Sir, I have a query.
Yes, please.
Sir, in the last second line, we convert into Cartesian form.
Mm-hmm.
So how to convert Cartesian form? I forgot.
Okay, fine. So this is your r, this is your theta. That is the polar form. Okay, what is the r? If you plot this x and y, this is your x, this is your y, okay? If you take the resultant, okay, you will get this r value.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and what is this angle? That is theta, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so in place of x, can I write x equals to r cos theta?
Yes, sir. And y
and equal to r sin theta?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So this one you already know. So this r vector resultant, can I write as x plus iy?
Yes, sir. X plus
okay.
Iy.
Now in place of x, put the value of r cos theta. Okay. And in place of y, put the value of r sin theta. Okay. Clear? So that's how you can convert. Okay, look here, if you are taking this example, okay, 21 angle minus 100. Okay, just a minute. Okay, so suppose you want to convert this angle, this polar form, minus 100. Okay, so you can convert it like this. One will be the original, the real value will be 21 into cos of minus 100. And I hope you remember cos of minus theta and cos of plus theta, that value is same, isn't
it? Yes, sir.
Now, so this value will remain always positive.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that means cos of 100 degree, cos 21 into cos 100, and this value is in second coordinate. So ultimately you will get negative value. Because you can calculate the cos 100 value. Okay, that value will be negative. Okay, so after you multiply, you will get minus 3.65. Okay, clear? Next, plus 21 into sine of minus 100 into j, right? Now sine of minus 100, you can calculate using calculator. Okay, that value you will get as minus 20.68. Is it okay now?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay, so likewise you can calculate the 15.4 angle 1110, or if you want 15.4 angle 250. Okay, in both cases you will get same value. Okay, so now we are going to the next numerical. Okay, now in an RL,
please show the previous slide. I want to take a screenshot.
Okay, fine, take it.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, the next numerical, an RL series circuit has resistance of 20 ohm and inductance of 0.02 Henry. If the net impedance of the given circuit be 40 angle phi ohm, find out the value of phi and frequency of the circuit. Okay, so here, a resistance 20 ohm. So I already told you that whenever you are going to solve this kind of numerical, always draw the circuit diagram. Okay. Always draw the circuit diagram. So here the R value is given and inductance value is also given. Okay. that is 20 ohm, and L value is 0.02 Henry. It is not converted into ohm, so you have to do that. And it is applied across one certain voltage. That is not required here. Okay. Now, the net impedance is given as 40 angle phi. Okay. So Z value is 40 and phi value is unknown. Whether it is phi or theta, it's up to you. Okay. Now, how can you calculate? So before the calculation, you have to convert this L value into XL. Okay. So for that, you need the frequency. That is 2 pi F into L. Now, F value is not known to you. So that is one variable. Okay. Now, R plus J XL. That value is your Z. Okay. Clear? So, and what is, if you convert this into polar form, what will you get? Z angle theta equals to root under of R square plus XL square angle tan inverse XL by R. Okay, so now theta value you will get from here. Okay, and Z value you can get from here. Okay, now what is the Z value? That is already known as 40, right? So now I am equating the magnitude first. So I can write 40 equals to root under of 20 square plus XL square. So from here you can calculate the XL value. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that XL value, calculate that. Okay. XL value you can calculate, and the same value you will get like this, 34.64. Okay. 34.64. Now XL value you have. So from here you can calculate the L value very easily. Oh, sorry, for the F value, the frequency value. Okay. That value is XL by 2 pi into L. Okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
So from here you can calculate the frequency value. That frequency value you will get as same, 276 hertz. Okay. Now, your XL value is already known to you. So XL by R tan inverse, if you take the theta value, you will get. Whether it is theta or phi, it's up to you. Okay. There is one writing mistake here. Here it is written theta, here it is written phi. So there is one writing mistake here. Okay. So is that clear how to calculate this one? Here one process is done. I am solving this numerical in another process. Okay, so now you have two types of solving process. Okay, now it's up to you what process suits you. Okay, any query till now? Any query till now, or do I need to repeat?
No, sir.
Okay, good.
No, sir.
So, okay, fine. So now the first numerical is solved. Now the second numerical, a series circuit has the resistance of 4 ohm and inductance of 0.01 Henry. Find out the impedance at 100 Hertz and 500 Hertz. Okay, this one is very simple. Resistance and inductance. Resistor and inductors are connected in series. Okay, R, this is L. So you have to convert the XL, and during the conversion you have two types of frequency. One is 100 hertz, another one is 500 hertz. So if you take the F equal to 100 hertz, you have a particular XL value. Okay, then for 100 hertz, calculate the magnitude of the impedance and then the angle. So you will get a certain impedance, magnitude and angle. Okay, then calculate the Z value for 50 hertz. Okay, this is root under of 4 squared because resistance is staying always constant. And for 500 hertz, the frequency is 500 and the XL value is getting changed. And this one is written here. Okay, and the angle will be just like the previous, tan inverse XL, that is 31.4 divided by 4. So that's how you will get the 82.75.